Alright, we have brake pads on our car and we want to know how much of the pad is left and when do I have to replace the pads. And we are just talking about normal wear and tear, not about any complications on this. So there we see the brake caliper. And we are looking on both sides. So somewhere on the brake caliper you will find an indicator, a wear indicator. On this car, at least. Let's see if I can show this here. On the right side we see it. It's difficult with the camera to get to those locations, depending how big the hole is here in your rim. So there is this indicator. And the indicator will touch the brake rotor, and once it touches it, it will make a noise. It will squeal and squeak. Let me see if I can get in from here. Oh, there we see it a little bit better. So it's like a little metal spring on there, like a flat piece. And when the pad wears down, this little metal piece here, this one here, is going to touch the rotor and then it will squeal. So this one has a gap of 5 millimeters, so it's a rear brake. And we have 5 millimeter left before it makes that noise. At that point, there will be 2 millimeter of pad left, and then we really need to replace the pad. Now, when it starts squealing, if we do it very fast, that we hear the squealing when we brake. So usually it's like you push your brake pedal and you hear the noise like that. If you then change the pads immediately, you can probably save the disc. Here I'm looking behind the disc. There is not much to see because of some metal shielding. Let's go over to the front and look at the front brakes on this car. So there we too have a disc and a caliper there. Let's look up here. There is no indicator on this side. So it's probably from the other side. Let's move it around. You could try to measure here the distance, but this gap here will show you how thick the pad is, but it's not the right side. Let's try the other side. There it is. Oh, wonderful. There you can see it very good. And for sure, you should do this by with a cold car. Like, if you go in here with a camera, it's pretty hot, or with your fingers. It's hot when you drive or after you're driving. So don't do this with a hot vehicle like this one. Cool down for a while. So here we have it. There's the 5 millimeter gap on this one. New ones have 11 millimeter. Two when it starts squealing. So this thing has 50% of its life done or left after 58,000 miles. Let's have a look at new pads. There's my receipt. I need those pads. I have lifetime warranty, believe it or not. This is the pad that goes into the pistons. There's those metal brackets on there. And the other side, the side where the indicator is here. There's this little spring indicator. You can see this. Now let me get my measuring stick out here so we can measure here. 11 millimeters thickness. And this one is showing or touching the rotor at 2 millimeters. So you can use 9 millimeters of the pad. And when it touches the rotor, it makes a noise. You can hear how that metal makes a noise already here. So if that goes on the rotor and rides along there, it will squeal pretty hard and you will notice immediately. So you can basically drive until you hear the squealing noise and then you have to replace them. Alright, so I hope that helps in understanding how this works.